By the time Dream Drop Distance begins, Diz is stuck in the Realm of Darkness with Aqua, where he found himself after the explosion from the encoder. This is probably going to be very important information come Kingdom Hearts 3, so keep it in mind. For now though, let's move forward. Given the fact that by now, Ansem has been defeated and Xemnas has been defeated and Organization 13 has been defeated, that should mean that the worst is over, right? You'd think, but no. Because as it turns out, now that Xehanort's Heartless, Ansem, and his nobody Xemnas have both been defeated, that now means that Xehanort himself can be revived. That, as you can imagine, would be a threat greater than any other our heroes have faced so far, and Yensid knows that perfectly well. He and Mickey realize that Xehanort's return is a very real possibility and would be disastrous for everyone, and as such, they need to start preparing for it. And how do they plan to do that? They are going to do that by adding more Keyblade Masters to their ranks, something that they don't have nearly enough of to counter forthcoming threats. Though Sora and Riku have accomplished a great deal since their departure from Destiny Islands, they're still not officially Keyblade Masters. As such, they're both summoned by Yensid, who declares that the two of them must each undertake the Mark of Mastery to become proper Keyblade Masters. The two are separated from each other for their exams, and told that as part of their test, they must travel to several worlds that were previously destroyed by Heartless, but have since been restored following the defeat of the evil Ansem. These worlds now rest in a state of deep sleep, and it is up to Riku and Sora to unlock their keyholes and return them to the Realm of Light and complete their restoration. Several monumental things come to light during Sora and Riku's exam. Throughout their exams, the two of them repeatedly encounter the resurrected Ansem and Xemnas, who are accompanied by a mysterious youth. That mysterious figure is eventually revealed to be a younger version of Xehanort himself, who, as it turns out, can time travel. Much like what happened with the Mark of Mastery for Terra back during the events of Birth by Sleep, Sora's exam is also manipulated by outside forces, as Xehanort, in several ways, tries to sway him to the dark side, and make him embrace whatever little darkness he has inside of him. When all the worlds have been restored to the Realm of Light, that culminates in Sora finding himself being transported to the world that never was, where the full extent of Xehanort's machinations is revealed. As it turns out, Xehanort's intention for creating Organization 13 is much, much more devious than just creating a second Kingdom Hearts. His intention was to imbue every one of the organization's members with a piece of himself, essentially creating several clones of himself. He would then use the 13 members of the organization and pit them against 7 Warriors of Light, and thus recreate the events of the Keyblade War, and recreate the X-Blade. Due to a few members of the organization, such as Roxas and Axel, unpredictably showing more independence than Xehanort had anticipated, that plan was thwarted, but only temporarily so. Now, with Ansem, Xemnas, Zigbar, and the young version of Xehanort, that plan is now closer to fruition than ever, and Xehanort intends to make Sora the 13th and final member of the organization. Sora is, as you might expect, opposed to that idea. A battle between himself and Xemnas ensues, and though Sora manages to win, after many trials and tribulations faced in the world that never was, and the battle with Xemnas itself, his heart is damaged, and he falls into a comatose state. The young Xehanort takes unconscious Sora to the castle in the world that never was, but to protect his heart from being completely swallowed by darkness, it is enveloped by the Keyblade armor of Ventus, whose heart, as you might remember, found refuge within a young Sora after the events of Birth by Sleep. It then falls to Riku to find and rescue Sora. After squaring off and successfully defeating Ansem once again, he manages to make his way to the throne room of the castle, where the comatose Sora is being held, where Riku then engages in a duel with the young Xehanort. Though Riku manages to win, it turns out that by the time the battle is over, Xehanort himself has been successfully revived, much to the dread of everyone. Xehanort prepares to place a piece of his heart within Sora and turn him into a clone of himself, as per his plan. But Sora is rescued at the last minute by Lee. Who the hell is Lee? He is the human form of the nobody we all know as Axel, and also, by the way, is a Keyblade wielder. Another dramatic battle occurs between the two opposing sides, but after a grueling fight, Xehanort is, at least temporarily, defeated, and his plans stopped from coming to fruition. Xehanort declares that this is only a temporary setback, and that he will have his revenge. Following which he and the rest of the members of the reformed Organization 13 retreat. Riku brings back Sora's comatose body to Yensid's tower, where it falls to Riku once again to bring Sora back, fighting and defeating Sora within Ventus's armor. After defeating Sora successfully through a convoluted series of events which we don't really need to go into too much detail about, Riku finds himself in a version of Destiny Islands within Sora himself. What exactly is this? This, as it turns out, is important data hidden inside of Sora. And who hid it? None other than Ansem, the real Ansem himself. While Sora's memories were being restored after Chain of Memories. Here, Riku learns that Sora's ability to connect with the hearts of several key characters, such as Roxas and Ventus, is the key to bringing back those who have been lost. As you might have guessed, rescuing the likes of Ventus and Aqua is also going to be a vital task for the good guys. A digital recreation of Ansem the Wise also gives Riku a bottle with important data stored inside of it, telling him that that, too, is going to be important going forward. Once Riku comes back to the real world and Sora awakens, Yensid informs them that though both of them performed admirably in their marks of mastery, only Riku has been made a Keyblade Master, and that Sora, due to almost having fallen into complete darkness, failed his test. As a result of these events, Sora has also lost a fair bit of his strength and powers. Unshaken by his failure, Sora vows to regain his strengths and to train himself to be better able to use his abilities. In other interesting developments, Lee also reveals that he will be taking the Mark of Mastery exam as well. Yensid and Mickey also decide that the Seven Princesses of Light need to be protected against the fight to come against Organization 13. And for that, they need to train more Keyblade Masters, with Dream Drop Distance revealing in its closing minutes that Kairi, too, will be taking the test, as she can also wield a Keyblade. And that's it! That's the story of the Kingdom Hearts series from start to end. Well, not the end, but up until Kingdom Hearts 3, anyway. Given the long-winded and convoluted nature of the series, there is obviously a lot that we haven't discussed, or might have missed out on or skipped over. If you feel there was anything important that we should have talked about but didn't, tell us in your comments below. Also, let us know what other games or franchises you would like us to tackle in our future Story So Far features. We always love making these, and we hope you enjoy them as well.
And that about does it for this video. If you enjoyed what you watched and want to see more from Gaming Bolt, you can always hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell icon next to it. That way you will never miss any of our videos.